plant water relationship. In this chapter, we are going to study what type of relation is there between plants and water. Okay, now we know plants absorb many things from the surrounding. For example, plant absorbs minerals, water, carbon dioxide, salt, oxygen. But out of these things, water is the most essential part which is absorbed by the plant. If you see the part, 90 to 95% of water is present inside the plant. So, water is the most important or essential part of the plant. So, first of all, we need to see with the properties of water. 10 properties we have to see. How do we keep these properties in your mind? No? In short, the keyword you have to keep in mind, LIPSTAPAHR. Okay, so first we'll proceed with L. L means water is always liquid at room temperature. See, three states are there: liquid, solid, and gases. Okay, so water always appears or it is always present in the form of liquid at room temperature. This is first characteristics. Second one is I4, it is always inert. Inert means it never reacts with anything. And this inorganic substance means, see, organic substance means organic compound, means the compound which contains carbon atom. Inorganic means which do not contain carbon atom. So here, what is the formula of water? H2O means it do not contain carbon. So water is inert means it do not react with anything, and this inorganic substance means it do not contain carbon atom. Third one is P for pH. Its pH is always 7. Means it is always neutral in nature. Next one is S4. It is the best solvent for many solute to dissolve. Means many solutes like salt is there, sugar is there, many solutes are there which can be easily dissolved in the solvent. So here we have completed LIPS. L4, it is liquid at room temperature. I4, it is inert and it is inorganic. It do not react and it do not contain carbon compound. P4, its pH is always 7, means it is neutral in nature. S4, it is the best solvent for many solutes to dissolve. Now we are going to study TAPA. P4, it is the best transporting medium. Means with the help of water only many minerals, many salts, food material get transferred. So water acts as a best transporting medium. A for aqueous medium. Water acts as best aqueous medium means, say, inside the cell water is present, solvent is present, and because of this water many reactions are taking place. So you can say water acts as aqueous medium, best aqueous medium for all the reaction to take place. P4, it acts as a thermal buffer. Now, thermal buffer means what? Suppose this is water and in the surrounding lot of heat is there, high temperature is there. This water is having a tendency to absorb all the heat or temperature from the surrounding, and it maintains the temperature or heat inside the cell. So we can say it acts as a thermal buffer. Now next one is A. A means it has good adhesive and cohesive forces. Adhesive means the force of attraction between the same molecules. Cohesive means the force of attraction between the dissimilar molecules. That is called as adhesive and cohesive forces. So water is having best adhesive and cohesive forces, and because of this only water can easily transfer in the capillaries. Last one, second last, H means hydrogen bond is present between the water molecule. Hydrogen bond of one water molecule tightly holds the oxygen of another water molecule. Hydrogen of one water molecule tightly holds the oxygen of another water molecule, and in this way water molecules are tightly held to each other. And last point is it acts as an essential raw material for photosynthesis. Photosynthesis means preparation of food. So here water is acting as an important material for photosynthesis. So here we have completed 10 points. LIPSTAPAHR.